I just saw Won't You Be My Neighbor, and let me clarify, this is not a review. I'm simply just telling you to watch this movie, whether you're a fan of Mr. Rogers or not. I typically don't like documentaries based on people because there aren't a lot of people interesting enough to make an hour and a half movie about. But Mr. Rogers is one of the most interesting people you'll ever hear about, like the man who changed millions of lives. Mr. Rogers died in 2003, and when he died, PBS pretty much reran every episode. So growing up, I didn't have cable in my room, so I'd watch Mr. Rogers pretty much every day, and he taught me things that teachers would never talk about. I think there are a lot of flaws in the school system, but I think the biggest problem is not teaching kids to accept themselves and not to be an asshole. And because of Mr. Rogers, I learned why my parents are split up, when all the other kids had parents who were still together. As a kid, it never really made sense to me why my parents split up and why I only saw my dad on the weekends. Without that episode talking about divorce, I'd be blaming myself right now for their split up. And it makes me sad that my generation didn't have that guidance, and I'm insanely lucky I grew up watching Mr. Rogers. It worries me that kids nowadays look up to Logan Paul. I love the internet, but sometimes I wish it never existed. Putting your kids in front of an iPad all day is fucking awful parenting. Because when kids have the internet all to themselves, they're gonna watch people like Logan Paul and think it's cool to taser dead rats and film suicide victims. And someone like Mr. Rogers couldn't exist in this generation due to parents stopped giving a shit about raising their kids, and they stopped caring what they watch. But the impact he had on my parents' generation is fucking insane. The things he did and talked about, you just couldn't get away with that now. Parents now think kids are too young to be learning about death and divorce, but talking about world problems is healthy for a kid to understand life isn't perfect, and it teaches them how to react in that situation. I always felt different because of my ADHD, but Mr. Rogers helped me not worry about how different I am. And I'm not saying I'm not different, ADHD makes you a completely different person. But my mom didn't know how to tell me I'm different because she never met anyone with ADHD, my older brother never had any of the things I have. But Mr. Rogers made me feel like none of that mattered, and just as long as I'm happy with myself and I accept who I am, which is something I live by to this day. My point is, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood wasn't just a kid's show, it was an alternative lesson to kids to teach them important things schools wouldn't teach them. And this documentary does more than show his talent and the behind the scenes of the show. It shows the kids who he's affected, the topics that he talked about that no one else had the balls to talk about. He was a fucking badass, no other man could do what this guy did, and this documentary perfectly shows his legacy and his impact on kids. I mean, for fuck's sakes, he single-handedly saved PBS.
It's great to be able to stop when you've planned a thing that's wrong, and be able to do something else instead, and think this song. I can stop when I want to, can stop when I wish, can stop anytime. And what a good feeling to feel like this, and know that the feeling is really mine. Know that there's something deep inside that helps us become what we can. For a girl can be someday a lady, and a boy can be someday a man.
I think it's wonderful. I think it's wonderful. Looks like you just earned the $20 million.
If you're a parent, I highly suggest you show your kids Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood instead of shoving an iPad in front of them. I'm lucky to have lived in a generation where there wasn't an option for that. All I had was Mr. Rogers. Because of YouTube, I feel kids are gonna get dumber and dumber each generation, and they're gonna become such assholes who think being a dick is cool. Even if you're not familiar with Mr. Rogers, I suggest watching the movie. It's an incredibly interesting movie. I honestly thought this movie was just gonna talk about the good times they had on the show, but they really showed a lot of stuff I didn't even know about the show and him. He's a very interesting person, and this movie does him justice, showing how complex his life was and his personality was. I don't really want to spoil this movie or give away anything that happens that you may have not known about him. Because it's very entertaining to watch all this stuff you didn't know about him or the show and the criticism and all that. This is honestly the best slash well-made documentary you'll ever see. I haven't cried in a very long time because this past year I cried so much, pretty much daily, I stopped crying when I was sad. My depression got pretty bad this year, I just kept crying every day about the same things. Till eventually I couldn't anymore. And it makes me sad that I can't even fucking cry anymore. I grew up with people telling me I don't have emotions, that when I actually felt like I didn't have emotions, it scared me to think that they were right. But for the first time in a very long time, I actually teared up watching this movie, because it just really hit me hard. I'm so fucking, I hate this word, but blessed to have grown up watching Mr. Rogers and PBS. That's all I gotta say. By the way, I know I've been gone for about a month now. I've been a little busy this month. Not too busy to make a video, I just didn't feel like making a video when I was tired. And I have a longer video coming up, it just takes a while to edit, and that's why you have this short video. When it comes out, you'll see why it took so long to make. Also, I'm going camping on the 4th of August, so probably won't be uploading on the first week of August. I also won't be uploading at the end of August. I'm going to a Smashing Pumpkins concert, then right after going on vacation for Labor Day weekend. I know I've been rambling a lot, but thank you guys, I'm literally like addicted take hair away from 600 subscribers. Whether you're here for my funny moments content or my video essays, it means a lot, and, like, thank you.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood, a neighborly day for a beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine?